Hi, everybody. This is Rhea Davidson. Thanks for listening to the Dragonfly Effect. Today's episode includes Tammy, and she is a dragonfly caregiver. And we're really happy to have you here, Tammy. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you for having me.
So let's start off by having you tell us what you want to tell us about your family, and we'll go from there.
Well, my dragonfly was diagnosed in 2011, right before Christmas. She was diagnosed with bone cancer, osteosarcoma. It was the darkest days of our life. I mean, everything like stopped right at that moment. Time freezes. You know, the social worker comes around and they talk about different foundations or, you know, give kids the world and make a wish. And you don't even know what that is. I Googled it one day, just sitting in our room while she was having treatment. And then when I Googled it, it was like, wow, you know, it's totally different. Like, I really needed to see what this was about. Like 2 days later, out of nowhere, I get a call in our room. You know, there's a bag down here for the Dragonfly Foundation. You come and pick it up. I went down there, and there's like, my little girl loved to read and color and draw, do designs. That's exactly what was in that bag. And it lit up her whole face, you know, just doing the treatments and, you know, being sick all night. And it just, a lot goes on. Nobody sees behind them doors. And just to see that smile, it meant everything, a lot. And we cannot thank you enough for all you do for us and all the other families. Not only is it just about the gifts, it's about the love, the caring, just everything that you bring to the table and all the volunteers that come out and just embrace these kids. My little dragonfly and the sibling, I mean, they both go through so much. And as you know, Rhea, my dragonfly sibling had a separation anxiety and cried every time he didn't see me. And you took it upon yourself when we went to the Reds field when he didn't see me to comfort him and bring him to me in tears. And you kept making sure he was okay on the field, and you know, you engaged with him to make him feel comfortable. And that's what it's all about. It's the whole big picture. Everything from going to getting tickets to Cyclones games and everything. It's amazing. Just amazing. The picnics in Kings Island and concert. Garth Brooks. Who don't like Garth Brooks? You know, it's just everything you guys do for all of us. It's wonderful. I could not ask for a better foundation than yous.
Well, I know that you've told a story once that really resonated with me about the box. I don't know if you want to share
that. Oh, yes, the box. I was sitting in the little room. If you knew about these little rooms, they're so dark and so cold and so lonely. And I just sat there and it just came to me like, I'm in this little box, and it's so dark, so cold, and no one else can see you or feel you or touch you the way that you need it to be embraced. It's so empty inside. And even though you can express those feelings, they don't get it. And you lose so many families and so many friends and, you know, along the way, and you're in this box. And when you guys come along and deliver that package and put that smile, you know, we went to the Cyclones game in a suite, you know, it's like sunshine all over again. Like a little tape is coming off this box to where you see a light. And it's like it got peeled off and peeled off and peeled off and peeled off because we feel safe in your surroundings. I'm the caregiver. I'm the grandmother. I'm the legal guardian. And the situation I've been in with my dragonfly and sibling, I don't like leaving them anywhere. I was still scared of that. And knowing that I could leave my child at the landing with the volunteers that I can trust around them and embrace them and love them, it's like all this tape, all these layers are coming off this box. And it's like it all opened up to where I could just see the light again. And I'm still seeing the light through your guys' eyes. It's like nothing ever before. Like, amazing. Just totally amazing what you've all done for us. And thank you for that light. I'm not in that box anymore. We're not in that box anymore.
So what's your favorite story that you've seen involving another family that you during an experience or at the landing or that you've heard about the Dragonfly Effect?
Another gentleman who I see occasionally years ago, it was always interesting to me. We always fist bump, but we didn't really speak that much. And he needed help, and you reached out, and I responded, and I went to his apartment to help him move. Mm-hmm. And it's like listening to him talk and his story and the family not being around, and, you know, it makes you feel thankful for what you do have. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, he's not here anymore, but I'm glad I had that time with him. You think that you're the only one. Mm-hmm. You know, and when you meet these families, you're not. You're brought together in different ways. Even though they're different cancers or blood disease, it's like you're still going through it. And we all understand it. Other little stories, like another little girl, you know, when we were first in the hospital, she's making all this racket out in the hallway, as I told you before. Mm-hmm. You know, and you look out the door like, what's going on? You know, we're here for this. Why are we making all this noise? But I didn't get it at that time. And all I do is look out the door and there's this little girl, bald-headed girl, going down the hallway with these slippers and the ears come up and they make noise and they were giggling. And, you know, after a while being there, you get it. You really get it. You know, and I just love her so much. Unfortunately, again, she's not here. Mm-hmm. There's just so many families that you lose along the way that you get attached to. But there's so many families that are still here and we're fighting every day. Just because your cancer's gone, the treatments are gone, it doesn't stop there. Yeah. It does not stop there.
I know we've talked, not just you and me, but with other families too, about every bump, every bruise, every headache, every night sweat, fear.
Every.
Yeah, that it just continues and continues. And not just, as you mentioned, for the patient. I know that siblings can really be affected. And
it took us a long time to get our sibling to where he is.
Yeah.
You know, it's nice that now he can go wherever and I can go wherever. And, you know, but it's the support of all of you. I didn't have the family support. I had you, as you are my family.
Yeah.
You know, to help us get through everything.
You and I have talked about our billboards in the
yes.
past. So tell me what it's like for you to see our billboard. And oh by the
goodness.
Way, and I should explain, our current billboards have just the word Dragonfly. It's not .org, not the logo, no pictures of our kids.
That's all you need. It says everything. Just that one word, Dragonfly. You know, it's like when my mother had passed away and I'm driving to the cemetery, you know, and you're down and you're out and just everything, you know, comes to you in that moment. And all of a sudden you're going up a hill and there's a big sign of Dragonfly. You know, it makes you feel safe and comfort and just everything about it puts a smile on your face right at that moment, like going down the highway to Children's and you see two billboards, you know, on one side of the road of the yeah. highway, and then coming back, there's another. It just brightens your day, just the word Dragonfly, because I know what it means mm-hmm. to me.
And it's been interesting because a lot of people who've been marketers are like, oh, you did it wrong, or you should have had the .org. And my response is always, well, this was directed to our families, and
yes.
they already know our website. How many times a week do you visit our website?
Right. All the time. All the time.
Yeah.
See what's going on in the stories, new families. And, you know, you don't get to meet them new families like I didn't, you know, get to meet the families. I remember getting that first package going down on the elevator and then going back up. Me and another lady was standing in the elevator. Not a word spoken, but we're both holding these bags. And she smiled and I smiled and we both got off the elevator together. It was that moment. It felt intimate, strong moment without no words being spoken. Mm-hmm. And my friend knows who she is. Mm-hmm. We're friends today. We're like so close. And, you know, you don't have to say anything, you know, a lot of times. It's already spoken. Just like your sign, it, you don't have to say it all. It's already spoken. It's, Dragonfly says it all.
One of the events that always seems to be so popular with our families is our Parents' Night Out event, where families can come and drop off their kids, and we'll kind of watch over them for a couple hours while parents can go do something fun, or take the other sibling out, or just do something and know that they're Dragonfly and kids are taken care of. I know that you and some other families over the last couple years, I found out, have been doing something planned outside of Parents' Night Out. They've been meeting at a restaurant near the landing and really just getting together every couple weeks to meet. And I remember when I found out you guys were doing this, like totally organically, it just brought tears to my eyes to really know how much friendship you found through Dragonfly.
Oh, I can't tell you how many friendships. It's just, we're all there for each other, you know, even on the outside of the hurt and the pain through our children. There's a lot that goes on behind it, you know, that we share as parents that we can share with each other. It gets deep sometimes, and that's a safe place for us. Even at a restaurant, we cry, but we laugh, you know, and it's good to feel that. And all of us, you know, we meet at the restaurant, or we meet at each other's houses, and our kids get along great. They're like best of friends, and it's all because of yous. I mean, it goes back to the Dragonfly again. You know, we wouldn't have that bond without you. We wouldn't be able to get through what we went through and still going through without you. And the friendships is just, it's forever. It's forever.
Well, we've had teens date because, you know, they meet each other so frequently through Dragonfly.
Yeah.
We've had kids whose birthday parties are only Dragonfly kids.
Yeah.
3 to 12 patient events a week that we hold for our families is a great opportunity to connect or reconnect, to have something to look forward to just be together in a way that doesn't cost money. So we take donated tickets and suites, even at the last minute, to give to our families. We have a suite at US Bank Arena for every event through 2019, and hopefully we can continue that with the support of the community. And
We need your support.
We do. Yeah, you know how much we
need
do.
It. Yes.
Tell me about how both your kids have kind of grown through their experience with Dragonfly. We've talked about the friendships, but, and I know I've seen their confidence grow.
Oh, yes.
So do you want to share a little bit about that?
Oh, yes. My Dragonfly, she's, even when she went through treatment, she's like shy and reserved and real quiet and don't really say much. And, you know, through your foundation, you gave her the opportunity to come out of her shell and to talk at the gala. I mean, she was nervous. She spoke real fast.
It was adorable.
She did it in front of all these people. And it gave her so much confidence knowing that she did it. Mm-hmm. And you guys still continue to let her shine, like how to be kind, the group that came in, and the kindness. And, you know, she spoke about herself, and she really put it out there. More and more and more every day, the confidence is there. And she wrote so many stories about the Dragonfly Foundation at her school. And it's like, it comes from her heart and what she feels about the Dragonfly Foundation and what it has given to her, not only to me and a sibling, but to her. And she's the person that holds everything in, and she just lets it out on paper. Mm-hmm. She's going to be a writer one day.
And she really will be.
She's going to write that book, and you're going to be in it. I can't wait to read it one day.
Yeah. There are so many times where we've seen the kids come in, and it's fun to be able to watch them grow. And we love seeing them get older and have birthday parties and have, you know, especially the end of chemo parties and all those other things that they do, and to have something to look forward to. How has their experience impacted their compassion with other kids?
Like my Dragonfly, a little example, you know, when they go through what they go through, they learn words they shouldn't even learn. I know my Dragonfly, when she's in school, the kindness that comes out of her heart, she passes her cards around and gives candy with her card. like the Halloween, she wanted to get all the dragonfly flyers and the cards, and we put them in buckets for, you know, to pass out. And we just keep spreading the message, and it's deep. It needs to be spread. A couple of kids, when they don't feel good and they feel they know something's wrong with them, but they don't know what it is, they go to Jocelyn, and she'll tell them, well, do you got a fever? Do you feel aches and pains? Is your leg okay? You know, it's like she knows these things, and they shouldn't have to know those, but they do, unfortunately.
Your son, too.
Yes, absolutely.
He's phenomenal.
He is phenomenal.
Quite a character.
He's a character. He keeps you laughing every day.
He does. And I love how he dances. That's my favorite
thing.
Oh,
yes, and he sings. He does a lot of memes, imitates them, and he keeps us laughing, keeps his sister laughing.
Well, one of our programs is our student programs for non-affected kids to teach them about kindness, compassion, and philanthropy. It started because we were hearing from so many about bullying, and it wasn't just bullying from the kids. It was bullying from parents around the kids and really being examples of poor behavior. And so we tried to come up with a program where we could teach kids and have them take these lessons home so that parents might be a little bit more aware of the challenges that families go through.
Yes.
Because I don't think people can imagine what it's like.
They do get
bullied.
To
go through treatment.
Yeah. A lot of things were said about my dragonfly as well, about her not having the hair or the way she walks or the way she tries to run. You know, they make fun of her like, why are you galloping? You're galloping. You know, that's how she runs, you know, and don't be so harsh with these kids. Embrace them and love them and show your kindness to them. Mm-hmm. They're going through so much, have gone through so much. You need to embrace that. It's sad that the world is like this today, and the parents, you know, you go and talk to them and like, now my child, what's wrong with it? You know, you should be better than that. You should be better than that.
We all should.
Yes.
And I think a big component is not looking away. But when you look at someone, it shouldn't be to judge them.
Judge them, right.
You shouldn't look away from a need. And I think everybody has a need for kindness.
Yes.
So if you were to share with listeners the Dragonfly Effect, because that's the title of the podcast. I kind of like the name. How would you say the Dragonfly Effect is, and in relation to trying to communicate what our mission is? Because we have a hard time telling people what we do and the scope and scale that we do it. Because we're not just a one thing. We're not just events. We're not just a book publisher. We're not just a technology provider. You know, all these different things. How would you say what our mission is and what the Dragonfly Effect is?
You're a big support system. That is huge for all of us. Like you say, it's not just about the gifts. It's not about the events. It's so much bigger. You know, you guys, all of you, even the volunteers, they are amazing.
They are
amazing. And they go out of their way when they see a child, you know, sitting by themselves or, you know, over here crying, or they're too shy to get involved to do this or do that. Everybody steps up to make them feel comfortable and bring them together and bring them in. And that's what happened with us. I mean, it goes so far beyond that you don't even know. It goes so far beyond. The gifts are wonderful, but what you give to each and every family is your heart, your love, your compassion, the support, just everything above and beyond. And we couldn't ask for anything more.
Well, we're so grateful for an amazing staff, an incredible group of volunteers, and all the support that make all the things
make
that we do possible.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
We couldn't do it without sponsorships, without donated goods and services, tickets and suites.
We need all of it.
We do. And
yes.
And our families do. So what would you like to see Dragonfly do moving forward?
I really don't see much different. I mean, I think you are already fulfilling every need that's possible. I mean, for us, I can't speak for everybody else, but what I do see surrounding me, I already see that I don't think there's anything more that you can do.
Well, hopefully we can continue to grow them
and
help more families.
Continue to do more.
But I'm glad we're doing the right things.
Absolutely. Absolutely. We just need more volunteers and, more support and more donations and to keep it going. It doesn't stop here.
Exactly.
We want it to keep going. You know, there's so many new diagnoses every day.
Yeah.
And so many new families, and it's heartbreaking.
Yeah, we send about 30 to 40 new diagnosis care bags to the hospital every month. And with Cincinnati Children's now being number one, they're getting an influx of new patients and have told us to expect so many more.
And remember, if you have tickets or anything you don't want, donate them, gift cards, whatever laying around. We know that y'all don't use them.
That's so true. Well, and it doesn't take much to make a smile.
It doesn't. No, like $10 a Starbucks for, a child and a family in the hospital. It's a lot.
It is.
You don't
a tank
think it
of
is,
gas.
But it's a lot. Tank of gas. Yeah. We use so much gas going back and forth. You
People
know,
don't think about that kind of stuff.
No, no. And when you got a big vehicle like mine, because my child had to put her leg up, I had to have a big, big
and a
vehicle.
Wheelchair and a
the wheelchair
scooter.
To lug in there. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Again, please, people, if there's any way to support families like Tammy's, please go to dragonfly.org, share this podcast. Have a great day, everybody.
Here's your chance to help a family in need. To make a donation or to volunteer, just go to dragonfly.org.